Hi friends, this is Jasdeep here again making a new video on how to crack US visitor visa. I've received a lot of comments from my friends asking like how to crack this visa, how I was able to get, how my family was able to get. I'm telling you, it's not something complex, it's simple logic, and we are going to discuss about it here. So friends, the US interview visa process has certain questions and you have to answer them correctly. Now these questions revolve around two basic hypotheses. First, why do you want to go US? Why only US is your destination? And the second is that you'll be returning to your home country. So the US embassy needs some sort of an assurance that there's a reason for which you'll have to return to your home country. So starting on with the first question is always, why US? In that, many people say US is a developed country, you want to see that. Some people say it's a great country. Well, there are many other countries which are better than US, which are developed as well. Here, what we are supposed to answer is something that is only pertinent to US. For example, you want to see Statue of Liberty, or you want to go there with your wife and see the Miami Beach. Lastly, you can also say that your son stays there or your relative stays there and you want to pay them a visit, which is only possible if you go to US. Now friends, the second question that you can expect from them will be, which all countries you have been apart from US? Now this is a tricky question. So this question will encompass two things. Firstly, your credibility of return, and secondly, your financial background. They can get to know that from your passport itself, because it has all the details of the visa and your immigration stamps. So you have to be very honest and tell them which all countries you have been to. And if it's like Asian countries, it's good, but if you have been to like Europe or Canada, that would be a further good point. The third question that they'll be asking you is, what do you do for a living? In this question, they want to see whether you will be able to sustain your expenses in US. The answer to this question should be, what's the job description you're working at? And secondly, how much you earn per annum. For this, you should also carry on supporting documents, including your past 2 months salary slips, your bank statement, and your job recruitment letter. That would be helpful. Now, the fourth question would be an extension of the third question itself. They'll like to know why you would come back. Here, you should emphasize on four important parameters. Firstly, if you have any dependents, where you could say your aged parents or your kids studying in your home country. The second thing you can focus on is if you have a government job or a stable job, which you have already answered in the third question. The third thing is about any property that you have. So carry on the property papers, which will be helpful. They might not ask for it, they may ask for it, but that's going to increase your credibility. And the fourth thing would be if you have any business running here. Then you have to carry documents regarding your business registration, name of your business, if you have the annual income statements and all that. The last question would be, where in US are you going? If in the application you have mentioned that you are going to pay a visit to your kid or some family relative, then do mention about them and the place where they live. If not, then you'll have to tell about the first destination that you'll be landing in and any hotel or residency where you have booked your slot. So this will be telling them about whether you have a definite plan for US or you are just going for some random visit. If you prepare these questions properly, there's no chance that you are going to not succeed in your US interview process. You'll be able to convince them that yes, you are a genuine visitor and you will be returning back after your visit. Friends, if you like my video, please click on the subscribe button and do like it. Thank you so much.